Hello everyone, my name is Irina, and in this video I want to explain the basics of spectral clustering methods for you. One of the most common clustering methods, as you maybe already know, is k-means. It works well for datasets where points form hyperspherical complex clusters. You can see that in the picture. However, when clusters are of different shapes, such as elongated, ring-shaped forms, the algorithm performs badly. Let's examine the toy dataset, which consists of two ring-shaped clusters with 10 points in each group. As you can see, for such dataset, k-means fails to deliver the correct clusters. For such situations, other clustering methods are used, and one of them is spectral clustering, which is discussed further on. So, let's start with spectral clustering. In the first step, similarity graphic is constructed for the dataset. Each node in the graph represents a certain data point. Two nodes are connected by an edge if the distance between their feature vectors is lower than a certain number epsilon. In our case, graph consists of two connected components, the first one and the second one. Let k represent that number. Each component corresponds to one ring-shaped cluster. The epsilon used is equal to 0.62. So every two data points, for example this one and this one, are connected if the distance between them is lower than 0.62. So here is the distance is 0.618, it's lower than epsilon, then we connect these components. Spectral clustering methods use numerical linear algebra to determine the clusters by working with connected components of the graph. Secondly, adjacency matrix is built from the similarity graph. It is a square matrix with number of rows and columns equal to amount of data points. In our case, the matrix size is 20 by 20. Elements of the matrix indicate whether pairs of vertices in the graph are connected or not. If they are connected, value is 1, otherwise 0. If the graph is undirected, the adjacency matrix is also symmetric. After adjacency matrix has been built, diagonal and Laplacian matrices are generated. Diagonal matrix size is the same as adjacency matrix. It has non-zero values only on the main diagonal. And they correspond to degree of each graph vertex. In other words, each diagonal value equals to the sum of values of the adjacency matrix in the corresponding row. For instance, second vertex had two ones in the adjacency matrix. So element on position 2, 2 is 2. From diagonal matrix, Laplacian is built, and it is one of the main components for proceeding spectral clustering. It represents the element-wise difference of diagonal and adjacency matrices obtained before. The Laplacian L is symmetric and positive semi-definite. We can find a set of M orthonormal eigenvectors, which correspond to M non-negative and increasing eigenvalues. The smallest eigenvalue of L is 0, and its multiplicity equals to the number of connected components in the similarity graph. In our case, if you remember, we went to have two clusters, so two eigenvectors are used. Eigenvectors corresponding to the smallest eigenvalues provide us with new numeric features, which will be used for clustering instead of the original ones. In particular, given a prescribed number k of clusters, k eigenvectors corresponding to the smallest eigenvalues of Laplacian are computed. These vectors finally represent the columns of new feature matrix. In our example, we know that there should be two clusters, two eigenvectors, the first one and the second one, which correspond to the smallest eigenvalues, are binded in a new matrix with 20 data points and two features. For instance, the first data point now is represented by two values, 0.32 and 0. Rows highlighted with green belong to the first cluster, others to the second one. With that new representation, data points can be easily divided into two groups for future k-means. This can be easily seen on the picture. Here is the first group, and here is the second group. To sum up, k-means works well for datasets that consist of ball-shaped clusters, but fails for other types of cluster structures. Spectral clustering methods work well with such cluster shapes as rings elongated forms. So that's all for now. Have a nice day.